Hello, welcome back to Kaiserreich. We've got a bit of a tough situation on our hands with the Wolves of the Rocky Mountains descending on us west here, or from the west, into Texas and so on and so forth. Hopefully, though, we can try for some sort of encirclement of Delaware. But we do have to cross this river, but they've only got militias here, so we should be able to do it. And then we need to encircle these guys in Norfolk, and then push down south, possibly on them. Like, if we take Delaware here, and push basically to here, we have an encirclement. No, there's straight here, never mind. If we push to here, we have an encirclement, in which case we can push these guys up north, which will free them up from this spot, and we can send them somewhere else. Unsure as to where, though, possibly to the west. We've got more troops heading west right now, which we'll, you know, sorely need. We are getting our shit kicked in. Jed, don't do that. I was gonna attack that just to remove some of the burden there. Sometimes you have to counterattack like this just to get them to stop attacking you. This guy is gonna get pushed in. That will just have to happen. Do we even have any mountain troops at all? Don't think so. We need to get that in order to defend the... These are the Rockies, aren't they? All the way down to New Mexico. That seems... intense for the Rockies. I don't know if literally all of these are the Rockies. But yeah, let's see. These guys are actually suffering attrition already. But I do want an encirclement. I don't want to just dislodge them. Dislodging them is all well and good, but if we can get an actual encirclement, we can straight up delete the troops. Also, this is not good. There we go. If this gets taken, these guys get encircled, so we can't let that happen. It's all those Russian troops. Why are the Russian troops fighting for the CSA? Aren't the Russian troops fighting for the PSA as well? Or there's Japanese and National France, yeah, and Canadian. Why is the Russian Republic sending troops for the syndicalists? Is it because they're social democrats? That supposedly puts them as, like, ideologically adjacent. I suppose it is. In modern parlance, that would not be the case. Germans are a bit ambitious there. If we could take this, that would be awesome. Balkan War. Not unexpected. It is the Balkans, but we gotta get airplanes or something down here because this is like this air superiority here is not great for us. Actually, no, I'm not gonna send any close air support. I'm gonna send a bunch of air wings, normal fighter wings, as well as actually no, I'll send some air support as well. We mostly just need to get the get the air superiority sort of contested, and we'll gradually take them down because they're using they're using bombers, Douglas B-18 Bolos, which we'll be able to shoot down with our. Actually, we can just set them to intercept. Honestly, wait, sorry, that's what we're on. Because yeah, they're dropping bombs on us, and if we can just intercept them, we can gradually wear down that supply of bombers, which will gradually give us air superiority. And we're actually pushing all the way into here and close to Philadelphia. If we can actually take Philadelphia, that would be great because the victory point and also the port. But I'm going to focus on that encirclement because we need all these troops to contribute to the various pushes that we're doing. Luckily, the CSA is not even trying anything over here now. They are still trying for something here, though, which is worrisome. I'll hold these guys now. Okay, cool. We're getting our organization back. Did we not even name these guys? We did not. I just called them the New England Detachment. So we got the Minutemen, New England Detachment, which is basically just militias. And Army 3, which I'm Norfolk Detachment. I was talking about how, like, I'm constantly shifting them around, so I may as well not name them, but... let's see. This stuff's still fucking scary. Why is why is the PSA just suddenly so fucking strong, dude? Is there anything we need to research now in terms of equipment? Yes, soon, though not yet. Having equipment research would be kind of good, I think. Let's recruit the next militias in Maryland. Training time, division recovery rate, and manpower, and we get Garands. Sure, I'll... I guess I'll do the Silver Legion, we don't even need the manpower or the, that's 50,000, that's a lot, but we don't need it right now, and we don't necessarily need the recovery rate, do we? No, we do. And we need the, well, we don't necessarily need the training time, but it would help quite a lot, a good deal, so... I'm gonna do that. I'm also gonna have a look at our generals just to see if we can't improve some of them. For example, giving Patton here something like... I mean, defensive doctrine would be insane right now. I think I'm gonna go with that one, even though long term it might not be the best. And also, charismatic would be really good as well. Let's have a look at these guys in the west. Can we give them anything that is helpful? Not necessarily. This one might help against the enemy, but it gives us less air superiority bonus in combat, I think, and the enemy. And we're not planning for us not to have air superiority, we're planning for us to have air superiority. So where are these guys? They're set up over here, so we're gonna give you infantry expert. And then the first state militias, we could give infantry expert as well. I believe these guys count as infantry divisions. Entrenchment would be awesome actually though, because they are basically meant to just defend. Yeah, I'm gonna give them ambusher, max entrenchment and bonus. And that puts us at 40 command power, which, I mean, we don't have anything else to spend it on really. These guys still exercising, that's fine. Submarines, are we producing any more submarines, actually? Yeah, we are. And how many do we have? We have a few. We could try to raid the CSA, though I'm guessing they're gonna have, like, some sort of Red Navy. It's gonna be hard to dislodge. These are professional troops. And after we take that, we also then have to push over towards Dover, which we'll have to possibly pursue these troops into Dover, and that might be a hard sell. Or like a hard proposition. Sultanate of Egypt has declared war on the Ottoman Empire. Iran declared war on the Ottoman Empire, so we've got the big, you know, Arab war that happens pretty much every game. Arab, Turkish, Persian. The cavalry of tomorrow. Let's see. What else can we go with here? Army Ranger Corps? Nope. We don't need the special forces yet. Military factory is nice. Rhode Island was where? There it is. I mean, having an extra military factory there is not the... Like, that... I'm not super, like, jazzed about that. Having it doesn't hurt, but we might lose it, so... Air doctrine stuff, we don't need that at all. The air war in the American Civil War is not insignificant, but it's barely... Like, it's not at all the deciding factor. This stuff does help us in Tennessee, though, and then we can get focus on swiftness, so we're gonna go with motorize the men. Rebellion in the Yemen. Another blow to the Sultan. Yup. We are actually breaking through here. Ashriki Kingdom joined the Cairo Pact. Oh, also, we should have one unit here move over. So we need this guy to attack, or to move in. And we need these guys to support afterwards, so that we avoid the river crossing penalty. But generally, just sending this guy in like this is kind of a bad idea, I think. Because then the enemy can just retake this tile once we move into this tile. But, as I said, I believe it to be a necessity to be able to actually win that battle. Yeah, see, they're still just, like, pushing in over here. It's not great. The Pacific States of America are actually doing way too well. This should not be allowed. Imagine if I, as the player, lose and the Pacific States of America win the Civil War. Because I've done such great damage to Jack Reed here. That would be quite the thing. They are pushing hard over here. Don't think we can hold this forever. I think it's a losing proposition, but... So long as we hold it, Jack Reed doesn't hold it, and so long as we hold it, we get the industry. And so long as we hold it, Jack Reed needs to contest it. Let's get a tank designer, as we get a light tank design here. Because we're still slightly out of time on the infantry here, or infantry equipment, and we can probably get that after that 35-day thing here. Actually, no, this is going to be pretty huge, because 5% soft attack, and this is defense breakthrough. You know what, I'm going to go with this. Can we get... This isn't actually... Oh yeah, this isn't going to impact the... effectiveness of the individual equipment, but it's going to make it faster to research. The enemy's going to have low hardness, so getting a lot of soft attack is probably going to be really good. Why are these guys just hanging around? And not actually moving to their tile? Or to their front line? There we go. Mashriki Kingdom has capitulated. Let's have a look at Europe again, CNTFAI, and Carlos Spain. Fighting it out. This Portugal thing, I'm still confused as to why this happens. But yeah, we've got Saudi Arabia, we've got Sultan of Yemen, Iran. Sorry, Sultanate of Egypt, my bad. I read the Sultanate, and then I read Sultanate, and then I read Yemen. Wonder if the German-French war is going to start. Democracy in Prussia, interesting. Caucasus direction. Hopefully this brings Russia into war with Germany, maybe, or something like that. I want the big powers here to be at war so they don't help out any of the sides here right now, because I think, like, generally speaking, our side is not the most attractive to help or to support. most attractive one, I believe, is possibly the Pacific States of America. They've got help from Canada and Japan and National France, while the CSA, so far as I can tell, only have help from Russia, and absurdly enough, it seems like only Russia is helping them. No, Union of Britain as well. No French troops, like from the Commune. Oh no, never mind. There are French troops. Why the Russians, though? Why male models? Oh shit. Gotta get this back. It's much harder to hold once you've lost the river. Okay, yeah, now the thing is happening that I was sort of afraid of. Should I even hold this tile? Yes, I should, because that means they can't attack this from multiple directions. Going to move these militiamen over as well, because we really, really need to take it over. And then we're going to send them west, I think. Because currently the threat is the PSA. The CSA generally are not doing anything, while the PSA are pushing hard. Qing declared war on the Shangqing Changguo. Yeah, this is just... this is dead, I think. Like this attack. Yeah. It's not gonna go well, that. Let's hope this works out, though. So I had to delete this from the playlist because I uploaded the VOD for the Democratic Japan game I'm doing on Twitch. I uploaded that VOD to YouTube and the video got straight up blocked due to the song. And it's the first time I've ever seen that before. So instead of just like taking all the ad revenue from the video, this specific Japanese company straight up blocked it from being able to be seen anywhere in the world. It said, like, blocked all countries, which was, like, very, very dramatic to read. Okay, so we got pushed out of here. That's fine, I guess. This stuff does not seem like it's gonna happen. We'll have to take this tile, I think. That would actually surround them as well. Strait connects these two, right? Not Dover in this. So we do still need to take this tile as well. What if we hold? Who are they supporting? Oh, they're supporting the Germans. Yeah, what if we hold and then regroup? And then maybe try to take this again. And then try to take Philadelphia and go around. It's going to extend the front line in a way that I actually don't want to do. Because then we need more troops to hold and we won't have as many troops to actually do the push. But this isn't going to happen because we're crossing a river and we've got straits and stuff. Or we could wait until they move some of the troops out. That wasn't a lot of troops, but it was troops. We don't have any close air support over here, so I'm gonna assign some. Also, I just realized I should probably be doing something over here. I should be bombing infrastructure behind the PSA. Because I could possibly be able to slow down their advance by just cutting them off from any and all supplies. Of course, they could get supplies from up here, but I think, let's see, four. Oh, actually, it's pretty much the same all over. So we'd have to bomb this zone and this zone as well. Just like that. It's only 100 bombers, so it's not going to make a massive impact at all. Why do we still not have air superiority, even though we've got fighters? I'll set one up to actually establish air superiority and not, there we go, and not intercept. Because the interceptors, interceptors aren't going to be in the air at all times, and I'm guessing that's why we get less air superiority. Also, this is worrisome. Hold. They just crossed a river, so hopefully, yeah, they're going to be low on pretty much everything. Like, they made a river crossing attack. Pin these guys. Then we can take back that tile. Integration of New England gains a core on New York and Maine. Or upstate New York and Maine. Where's upstate New York? That's this. Holy shit. We don't hold that, though. So I don't know why that happens. But no more militias. Should we do a push on the Syndicalist front? Keep in mind, we can't do these all the time. I was hoping to save that until we can just crush this stuff. To get that done fast. I'll save it again until we can get more troops into this tile. Or ready for this attack here. Yeah, there's just so many troops over here, we can't really take that. Streamline the tank production. What is this song? Avante forward. Alright. I'm not going to deploy them as green, even though we actually are doing well for manpower. With the, that actually wasn't the Silver Legion thing. So we are actually gaining manpower for some reason. Oh, it's probably because we got the chorus, of course. That makes sense. The Army requisitions civilian trucks. After Patton announced his motorization program for the new American Army, a proposal was sent to President Long to decide on the requisition of civilian vehicles in order to supply our fastly growing army. With this approval, we have begun seizing vehicles from the civilian populace, although to our surprise, some proud patriots line up next to our storages to volunteer their vehicles for the incoming fight. Pretty sure this happened in the PSA playthrough as well. Okay, I'm going to reassign some of these guys over towards here. They're just pushing way too hard over here. Let's try to take Philadelphia. I was going to keep these out of the army and then add them to these guys, but I've realized I'm literally only using them down there anyways, so may as well just add them to the army so they get the bonuses from Mr. Collins over here. General Collins. So we got the Silver Legion, Silver Legion and all that. This guy should be low on organization. Yep. Take that. Then we can possibly, potentially, attack Philadelphia from three tiles. Remove a unit down here because I'm not confident that the Germans will stay there. Now we're losing battles here. That's because we've got a lot of poorly equipped militias there. Actually, I'm going to send the... I'm gonna possibly regret doing this, but I'm gonna send these guys down there as well. Because the horse militias aren't necessarily the best at holding. Okay, now we need to wait until they're tired of trying to attack this. I'm going to try to attack Philadelphia immediately though. I'll keep him there for now. I'll try to make him help out. Oh, this is... yeah, of course. Yeah, there's a strait over there, which is hidden by the 3D model. Which is awesome. I didn't know that. I think I was attacking across there as well, without even realizing there was a strait there. I think I was just doing it because I was like, oh yeah, they're next to each other, so it makes sense. But yeah, there is a strait there, totally, and I completely missed it. Or just forgot it was there. Fuck it, I might just have to deploy all these troops and get them on the PSA front. Because we can still hold this, but, you know, the longer we hold, the stronger Reed gets. But we can still hold that. Alright, he's getting chonky. Look at that. How much equipment are we still producing? Dude, we can possibly... We don't need any more equipment there, but we can possibly create even more infantry divisions at a time. Because we have so much fucking equipment going in. I do still think that we need to hold on, just like scrape by until we can get the infantry with proper training out there, because I don't want them to be out there green. They're gonna end up green eventually anyways from casualties, but they're going to keep becoming more and more green, and then they're just gonna stay green forever if they're too far gone. But they could end up green. Due to casualties, it's not guaranteed because they could, at the same time, gain experience as they're taking casualties. So we could end up with experienced troops. So that's why I don't want to possibly waste them. I suppose I'm not gonna let them take Washington back again. Oh, he's not even bordering. Let's see that now. All right, well, we have had some ups and downs. Oh, this is slightly new, I think. But we've had some, or maybe not. We've had some ups and downs. We've had some troubles here. I still am confident in victory, though. And while I feel worried, I am also hopeful. Because we are going to be producing a lot more troops, and we are going to be getting more troops in the near future. Almost, yeah, they're gonna be done in February 1938, so next month. And those troops, I think, are going to go directly to the PSA line here, and they're going to start pushing them back. You can see they're low on organization and everything, so they're ripe for a counterattack. Once we can push down their or push back their professional troops, which they've got all over here, and create a situation where we can hold a bit more confidently here. We can reassign some of these weaker troops to spots where they can try to hold instead of pushing. Like, for example, they can hold around here with these guys. And they can possibly actually not hold here because we need professional troops here. And yeah, it'll be better, basically. We'll be able to push the PSA possibly to the Rockies again, hold those with some professional troops, and then reassign the militia somewhere else. Either way, we are at the end of the episode. I'm going to actually check the casualties, even though they're fucking complicated to check out. American Union State, 331,000. PSA, 109,000. 343,000 for the CSA. Not correct. This cannot be correct. It's just, those casualties are way too low. I refuse to believe that we've only taken 331,000, and they've only taken 463,000 collectively. That seems so low from like how long this war's been going. I mean, it's only 1938. Man, you're right. It's just taking so long to like gradually take territory bit by bit, or lose it, as in the case of the West. But yeah, we're gonna retake the West once we get those troops back, then reassign them wherever we need them. Thank you so much for watching. If you are interested, you can find me on Twitter in the description down below, Discord as well, and Patreon if you'd like to support me financially. And then finally, as I mentioned, I'm doing a Democratic Japan game on Twitch. You can check that out if you're interested. The VODs will be going up on YouTube, so you can catch up and then join us on Twitch to join the conversation. Live chat and stuff is always a lot of fun. Anyways, that is about it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.